Well, welcome back to the studio. Today I'm working on one of our limited original G. Clays, a painting that I did last year called Rock House Homestead. And this is a home that has been in this family many, 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 many years. And right now I'm going to be working in this area. I've already worked on the sky. I've repainted the roof on the barn, and on the barn, this part of the roof is more upright, so it receives less sunlight than the flatter part of the roof. So the more upright plane is darker, the flatter plane, which gets more light from above, is lighter. Now I'm going to do a little highlighting on that John Deere tractor. This was very special. Did the painting for a young lady named Amanda and her husband, and this is the home that's been in their family for many, many years, and this was her grandfather's John Deere tractor, and he just loved it. The kids got to ride on it and with him, and he'd make them feel like they were driving. Just really very, very special. So this barn is actually on a different part of the property than the home, but we wanted to move it into the painting so that they'd have that as a remembrance. So I just am highlighting this where the sun is catching it. Most of the tractor's in the shadow of the barn, but the front out here is highlighted. So I just accentuate that. We call these G. Clays limited originals because they're hand embellished, and I go back on each one and paint so that no two, even though that they're within an addition, no two of them are exactly alike. So that's why we call them limited originals. They're in an addition, which is limited, and then each one is an original in itself because every one is different. So I just want to put a few little highlights there. Come in here and highlight these tires. Sun's hitting them. This highlight I make a little bluer so it's not quite as bright. And now this is Amanda's dad that has asked me to do this G. Clay, and he's asked me to add a deer in there, a buck. So I'm going to do that. First of all, though, I'm going to do a little bit of a highlight on the corn behind the barn. And I'm just doing a little mixture of my green that I used for the tractor, plus a little bit of yellow, plus some mud, which is alizarin crimson, plus ultramarine blue, and then some white. And this just makes a real soft pale gold for the tassels on the tops of that corn. I just don't want it to be real bright because I want it to stay back in the background, but I do want to give this just a little bit of extra little highlight back in here. Just a little bit. Okay, that's that corn. Now for our deer. And I'm using a mixture of my mud plus liquin. And again, the mud is the alizarin crimson plus ultramarine blue. And Mark sent me a picture of a 10-point buck that he took at one of their feeders. So I'm just kind of blocking in the basic shape of his body. He's going to be coming out from behind the corn. He's got one leg. And I have the reference on my computer, on my laptop, and I've got it right beside my easel and palette on a tabouret. So he's coming out from behind. May have his legs a little bit thick, but I can come back and change that. Again, I'm using my mud plus ultramarine, plus a little bit, I've added just a touch of white in there and a little touch of cadmium orange for this that I'm using now. That buck's just coming out. He's just peeking out around the picking out around the corn. And there's his head. And this guy has a beautiful rack. His antlers are just really pretty. And I'm bracing on my mall stick. We got this at Container Store years ago. It's used for lifting clothes off of a high clothes rack. Use it in stores and things. But it hooks over the top of my easel and it makes a wonderful mall stick. I can just brace my wrist on it and my hand, and then I can steady my hand as I paint. I'll have to come back and do a little refining on this, but this is just kind of getting my basic shape here for my rack. This guy is really pretty. Got a really nice rack. He's a 10-point buck. Again, I'm just kind of blocking in his basic shape. His nose is dark. He's got a little lighter here around his nose and his eye. It comes back up under his jaw and down his neck here, just a little bit lighter. He's sneaking up here. He's looking around to see if anybody left anything good out that he can get to. Maybe somebody dribbled a little grain. Maybe there's a bird block out there or something that he can get to. Or they may have put a salt block out. A lot of ranchers do that. Put salt blocks out for the deer. Now his nose is just a little bit big, so I can come back with a clean brush and I jiggle it around in my thinner and then use tissue to clean that out. I can come back then and lift up some of this that I've gone too big here. So I can just lift that up. He's got a little dark under here. Got him a little bit too heavy. He looks like a reindeer now. Got him a little too heavy in there, so I can just come back and lift that line up. Also just a little bit big right there, and just a little bit small. It's just pushing and pulling is what this is called. You just kind of keep working back in till you get it right. And still just a little bit big on his nose. Ooh, I didn't get my brush clean. I can just go and lift that back out. getting about the right size now. A little bit more. He's got a little dished face, so. That's too much. I say it's just pushing and pulling, coming back and forth. A little bit more to shape his nose. His little muzzle. Just bring a little more dark back in here, and I'm just going to brace on the canvas where it's not painted. And there's our deer. There's our buck. Point this antler just a little bit. It's a little bit big. And again, I can just come back and lift that paint up off the giclée. These are printed in inks that have a light fastness of 250 years, so they will last long beyond us. And then they're also coated with an ultraviolet varnish, which protects it from sunlight so that they will not fade. And then I come back in and paint with oil, and at the end I will put a protective gel coat on the giclée. And then it'll be ready to go off to the collector. I thank you for watching my YouTube videos. Please subscribe to my channel. And if you would like to see the complete step-by-step process of this piece, as well as others I do, visit my blog. The address is in the description below the video. It's also on the final frame of the YouTube video. And so I really appreciate you watching. You have a wonderful, wonderful day, and please always feel free to ask questions.